So PayPal treated me like garbage, and I began using gold money for people to buy my newsletter because being frozen twice by PayPal for no reason when I'm not a scumbag, I'm not a scammer, I'm just a journalist trying to stay afloat, trying to pay my costs without using credit cards, trying to pay for everything, keep everything within my means, you know, just be a decent person. So here gold money is good to me, and here gold money doesn't block my account, even though I'm one of the most controversial journalists in the US, because they are committed to giving everybody access to gold. They're like what PayPal would be if PayPal actually had any kind of spine whatsoever. So I'm sure gold money is taking all kinds of heat on the back end, but all I'm seeing is on the front end that when you search on YouTube for their name, they're now being disparaged, and some guy with a Siamese cat is telling people to withdraw their money. Sorry, that's slander. Sorry, you can be sued by that company if they're losing money because you're telling people to withdraw. And why withdraw? So if you guys want to use the link in the description below, I will receive a small commission and you will get a bonus, I believe, on your first deposit. But either way, I want to use this opportunity to just say what a great company they are, and they accept Bitcoin. I don't know of another company that's publicly traded that allows you to convert your Bitcoin or other cryptocurrencies into gold within a matter of seconds or minutes. That's mind-blowing. Again, they're not a mom-and-pop shop. They've been in business since, I think, 2001. They have a million something customers, and I promote them because I really believe in the service. I can only promote something that I like.
And the great thing about controversy, you know, I would protest gravity if I thought it was going to get me buzz.
The next David Seaman claim I would like to address is that he is doing all this to sell copies of this book. That's not the criticism we're making, David. You've just changed the subject and not addressed the actual criticism. The criticism is this, is we believe that you are covering all this to self-promote yourself, and your book in the past basically is a working document on exactly what you've been doing and what we've been exposing. You know, your claim that you would protest gravity if it would generate a buzz for yourself is exactly what you're doing, and that's what we're exposing. That's why we show people this book.
For sure, Pizzagate has elevated my profile. I'm both grateful for it and a little stressed out by it, to be honest.
When you go out and you claim that your friend that you haven't been in touch with for years was killed over Pizzagate, that is a bullshit lie that you use to generate buzz and generate sympathy and profits for yourself and profits for George Soros, as I've already shown, because people went and supported your BitGold crap, which is a George Soros fund. And just because we're criticizing Zionism doesn't mean that we are anti-Semitic. That would be the same as when you were criticizing political leaders of America like Barack Obama, that would be like calling you a racist because you criticized a black person. Even though you weren't criticizing them over their race, all you were criticizing is their political policies. So it's the same non sequitur bullshit that people on the right hate when they're called racist for criticizing Obama, Well, criticizing Zionists and then calling us anti-Semite is doing the exact same thing. You people are a bunch of hypocrites.
I will leave it up to you for one thing. I will challenge you to a charity boxing match where you get to wear Israeli boxing gloves and I'm going to rock some Palestinian gloves and we're going to go at it for 12 rounds to raise money for the Pizzagate March. If you accept that challenge before the Pizzagate March, I will fly out to wherever the fuck you are, beat the living shit out of you, and then post it live all over the internet for all the people you've pissed off. Because you fucking deserve it, buddy. Alright? And if I ever see you in person, I'm going to confront you. Not physically, verbally, going to destroy you. The only way I'll physically confront you is in a charity boxing match in order to raise money. Because it's going to be a beatdown. And I don't want to get put in jail for beating the fuck out of someone. So that's where I'm going to leave it. David Seaman, you are a little fucking bitch. Uses censorship because you can't handle criticism. And no one should watch his crap. Everyone should boycott David Seaman because he's a lying, sensationalistic bullshit artist, a little fucking weasel who likes to call people anti-Semites and racists because he can't handle criticism. And that's the end of it.
And I resent that man who's been harassing me for months on YouTube, right? I resent Dean Fugere. I resent the months of harassment. I asked him to stop. Remember that guy? He was publishing all of his bullshit about me under fake names. Titus Frost, Imperator Truth. Oh, you're Emperor Truth? You're Emperor Truth? That's pretty pompous. Well, when he started attacking me and saying really anti-Semitic things about me, I did research on him, right? I do research on anybody who talks that much shit about me. So I did research into Titus Frost, into Mr. Emperor Truth, and it turns out his real name is Dean Fugere. And since the video I put out about him got 60,000 views, he's decided to start publishing under his real name. Good for you, Dean. Let your anti-Semitic views be tied to your real name. So Dean Fugere, he wrote a book a few years ago about space elevators, which don't exist, Dean. Space elevators are not a real thing. I checked outside this morning, looked outside, no space elevators in the sky. So this guy, Dean Fugere, wrote a whole fucking book about things that don't exist and has said anti-Semitic hateful things about me for months, and I'm frankly sick of it. And he's been tweeting hateful things at me. Guess what? We've archived every single one of your tweets toward me, Dean, and we've isolated all of the video clips where you're talking about me and where you're spreading anti-Semitic things about me. Now, I've only encountered a few genuine anti-Semites in my life, right? If you've ever encountered a racist, racists, they just think it's all about the blacks, right? The blacks this, the blacks that. If you've ever seen a real racist, that's all they think about is the blacks and the Jews and the Indians. And it's like, no, hold on a second. You smell like cat piss. You haven't paid your rent. You don't have a job. Maybe we start there before you go blaming the blacks for everything, right? The blacks are just trying to get by. They're just trying to live their lives. The Jews are just trying to get by, etc. Maybe it's not the blacks. Maybe you have an issue. And in the case of Dean Fugere, I figured him out. He's simply an anti-Semite. That's why he hates me so much. He's an anti-Semite. He despises me because I worship God, and that's pathetic. The few times in my past that I've encountered genuine anti-Semites, at first I'm like, wow, okay, this person is actually prejudging me on the basis of what they think they know about my religion. Wow, I'm actually being victimized. It's happened so infrequently that I try to study it when it happens, right? Anti-Semitism in America, I think, is so rare to find, right? I don't think it's that common. I don't think most people discount me before I open my mouth because I'm Jewish. But you know what, Dean Fugere? Since you're an anti-Semite who's been spreading bullshit about me for months, fuck you, Dean Fugere. Fuck you, anti-Semite. You know what that guy did at the human trafficking protest?
I flew out to the human trafficking protests this spring. A number of people tried to convince me not to go. Some things were said to me that made me feel like maybe my safety would be at risk. I went anyways, right? Flew out on my own money, went to DC, was on the literal front lines of this protest. And then I gave, I gave a speech and gave a group prayer, praying for the child victims. A non-denominational prayer, right? Just a prayer to God. I don't even speak Hebrew, never been to Israel, and yet Dean Fugere is obsessed with me. So here's the deal, Dean Fugere, you fucking Jew hater. Here's the deal. You're gonna post an apology video by Tuesday. You're going to post an apology video, and then you're gonna stop publishing things about me, right? Because either intentionally or unintentionally, you're slowing pedogate, right? I'm not one of these people. Judaism has nothing to do with pedo-Satanism. The Podestas are nominally Christian, right? So this guy, Dean Fugere, is inserting his anti-Semitic beliefs into the pedogate movement constantly, and I'm sick of it. I'm sick of the harassment. It is straight up religious harassment. It's harassing me simply because of my religion, and that is wrong. In America, we have First Amendment protection. So here's what I'm going to do. On Tuesday, if Dean Fugere has not yet published an apology video, and if he has not yet promised to stop spreading mistruths about me, then I simply walk down the sidewalk. I walk into the Denver Police Department, and I file a restraining order against Dean Fugere, because his level of unhinged hatred toward me because I'm a Jew, that level of hatred from the guy who wrote a book about space elevators, which are not real, folks. Space elevators are not a real thing, and Dean Fugere wrote a whole book about it. But this man confronted me at the trafficking protest, right? He comes up to me and tries to confront me for an interview. And it felt very childish. It felt like I was on a reality TV show. I was like, confront me? What? Confront me for what? And he had his wife with him, then his fiance. And the whole thing, I swear to God, the whole thing felt to me like a scene from The Real World, right? It felt like a scene from MTV's The Real World. I'm gonna confront you? Dude, inappropriate. We're at a child trafficking protest trying to raise awareness in front of the White House for child trafficking issues, and you want to confront me? Totally inappropriate, completely inappropriate time and place and tenor for that discussion. And it felt like a Real World segment. And then I find out later that his fiance, who was with him, she's literally a Real World contestant. That's what she does for a living. The MTV Real World. She's a reality TV contestant, folks. So Dean Fugere, go fuck yourself. You've said so many anti-Semitic things about me. You've harassed me on Twitter repeatedly, even after I identified it as personal harassment and asked you repeatedly to stop, which my lawyer asked me to do, and you didn't stop after that. So we've documented everything, Dean Fugere. Apology video by Tuesday, you anti-Semitic piece of shit. Or, again, I just walk down the sidewalk, I present every single tweet and video that I've saved, I give it to the Denver Police Department, who, they already know me, folks. I give it to the Denver Police Department, we fill out a restraining order, and then I'm gonna take Dean Fugere to criminal court for religious harassment, for religious discrimination. The First Amendment is one of the most sacred things in this country, not only because it protects my speech, but because you cannot harm me simply because I worship God. It's true, I worship Yahweh, I worship Jesus's dad, and this fucking anti-Semite, Dean Fugere, has been rubbing my name through the mud for months, and now it's my turn to seek action, right? Not gonna live like this for the rest of my life, Dean. Not gonna live with this for the rest of my life, Dean Fugere. So again, you either apologize by Tuesday morning or I'm filing a restraining order against you, which will stay on your record for a long time. And I don't want your money. As far as I've been able to tell, Dean Fugere doesn't have a pot to piss in. I don't need my Patreon page. That motherfucker needs his Patreon from what I've been able to determine. But I'm also going to file against him a criminal complaint. Religious discrimination for months is wrong. And although I pay a lot on security, although I'm personally heavily armed, when somebody hates me because of my religion for months on end, it starts to make me feel unsafe. I don't like feeling unsafe in my own country. So again, unless Dean Fugere apologizes to me on video by Tuesday, I'm filing a restraining order, and then I'm filing a complaint, a criminal complaint, because this is religious harassment. It has nothing to do with anything. How does this further pedogate Dean Fugere? How does this further saving the children? Or are you just trying to promote your reality TV star fiance? Fuck Dean Fugere. And by the way, I wonder if Patreon's terms of service, I wonder if they're aware that you're such an anti-Semite. Maybe we show them some of your videos where you go off on anti-Semitic rants. There's something wrong with that guy, and I'm pushing back. Again, you either apologize on video and promise to leave me alone from now on, or I'm just going to the Denver Police Department. Enough is enough. So hopefully that settles that one. I've answered the questions about Dean's claims about me. Now I've answered it. I don't want his money. As far as I can tell, he doesn't have any. This is a criminal concern. Months of harassment on the basis of the fact that I'm a Jew. There are laws against that, folks. And now that I feel unsafe, I'm happy to talk to law enforcement. We're not going to be victims in our own country. We are not going to be victims in our own country. You come after me because I was one of the first journalists to break Pizzagate. You come after me, you come after my religious heritage, and boy will I come after you. We're not going to be victims in our own country. So again, what was the intent for months of harassment of me? Months of focusing on my Judaism when I've never been to Israel, when I haven't been to synagogue in more than 10 years, when I eat bacon. Not exactly a hardcore Jew. Why has he been so obsessed with my religious views? Not safe, right? I don't feel safe anymore. And he's also provoked others, right? Some of the people who follow him are anti-Semites. So we're going to bring that fucking rat's nest down. Months of harassment in me, months of bullshit because I'm a Jew. Dean Fugere, you're filled with hate, Dean. You're a literal anti-Semite. And when people ask me, why aren't you sharing Titus Frost research? Because first of all, Titus Frost is not a real name. That's a goofy stage name. And second of all, he's not a credible human being. So I'm not going to share his research because it's hate-filled anti-Semitism.
People here are called anti-Semitic. What is your response to that as an Israeli Jew?
Well, it's a trick. We always use it.
You just called all Jews racist, and that you just ruined your whole campaign, because every single person out here has just heard someone say that every Jewish person is a racist. Do you think Jewish people are racist? No. And that is disgusting.
You're a persecuted people. Everyone picks on you. Yeah.
You know what the best quality my father has? Is he asks for nothing. I don't know what the fuck he's thinking right now. Look at that. Nothing. Nothing. I don't even know him. And I turned out perfectly fine without his input, okay?
I just figured out what your problem is. You hate Jews. Which is so odd, because your children are Jewish.
Don't play the Jew card, Larry.
I'm not playing any Jew card.
Seriously, it's used up.
You can't use up a Jew card. That's the whole point of a Jew card.
That's right. You can't use it up. It goes forever.